Hello, and welcome to Modern Infrastructure Wednesdays at Pulumi TV. I'm your host, David Flanagan, though you may know me from across the internet as RawCode. Today, we're taking a look at CrossGuard, policy as code for Pulumi programs. What is policy as code? Policy as code provides the ability for organizations to put guardrails in place to enforce compliance for the resources created by their Pulumi programs. Why do we need it? Well, Pulumi is an enabler, giving developers the framework to provision their own applications or even platforms. Using languages and toolchains that they already know allows them to be more autonomous and increase their velocity when shipping code. This is fantastic for developers, but much like a kid cycling downhill for the very first time, flying over the handlebars can almost be inevitable. And we want to stop that. We want developers to maintain their velocity, but provide a safety harness that stops them from doing something that could have a negative effect on other teams or even the organization. Need a more concrete example? Sure thing. Just 3 weeks ago, at the end of 2021, SEGA shared their story. They had a cloud security audit that discovered they were storing Steam keys, API tokens, and even AWS credentials were available to the public. Also in 2021, we've seen Sennheiser leak over 28,000 private customer records. A COVID-19 testing firm leaked over 50,000 private customer records. And the authorities in Ghana are investigating a breach that may have exposed the personal information of hundreds of thousands of citizens of the West African country. What do all of these cases have in common? They were all because of misconfiguration of S3 buckets. The source links are in the description, so go and check them out. Using policy as code, we can ensure that these types of misconfigurations do not happen again. Let's take a look. So let's start by creating a small Pulumi program to create an Amazon Web Services S3 bucket. First, we'll create a directory. Inside of this directory, we will run Pulumi new. We're going to say that we want an AWS program, and we're going to pick TypeScript. Perfect. Now we're going to go back up a directory, and we're going to create one more. This time, S3 bucket policy. Inside of our S3 bucket policy, we're going to run Pulumi policy new. From here, I can say AWS, and this time I'll choose Python. From here, I can run Pulumi preview. I enter my stack password, and Pulumi will tell me that it wants to create one S3 bucket. So if I run this again, adding policy pack, and then point it to the directory with our policy, CrossGuard is going to validate that no violations of our policy happen inside of our Pulumi program. And in fact, if I run this right now, we'll see that this works successfully. So let's modify our Pulumi program to violate the policy. If we open VS Code with both projects, so we'll start by taking a look at the policy that was created by Pulumi policy new. If we open the main.py file, we'll see that we have a function. This function is called S3 no public read validator. So you can probably guess what it does. It is going to ensure that any time a developer within our team or organization creates an S3 bucket, that it can't be publicly available. It does this by filtering down the type of resource that is being created. So here we are checking for a bucket. We're ensuring that ACL is inside of the properties passed to this resource. And if so, we want to make sure that it is never public read or public read write. If somebody creates an S3 bucket resource with an ACL of either of these public values, we are going to report a violation. And we will get enough information that we can see this when we run the Pulumi up on our program. So let's modify our S3 code to violate the policy. we can add ACL public read. And now if we run our policy pack again, we get the error. We are not allowed to get a preview or run Pulumi up because we have a mandatory enforcement of an S3 no public read with a nice error message telling us where we went wrong. But policies aren't just for S3. So let's do one more example. Now I'm going to create two more directories, Kubernetes service and Kubernetes service policy. Inside of the Kubernetes service, we're going to create a new Pulumi program. We're going to do Kubernetes go. And then in the Kubernetes service policy, we'll do Pulumi policy new. This time I can select Kubernetes in JavaScript. Perfect. So let's open this in VS Code and take a look. We have a JavaScript policy for Kubernetes. This policy pack has mandatory enforcement level, where it's going to validate resources of type service. If this service has a spec type of load balancer, it is going to report a violation saying that we are not allowed to make services within our Kubernetes cluster public. And if we open our Kubernetes program, we will see that this Pulumi program in Go creates a new deployment and currently does not violate our policy. If we run into Kubernetes service and run Pulumi preview, dash dash, policy pack, pointing it to our policy document, we should see that there are no violations. Perfect. So let's make a change to our project. We've decided that we now want to expose our deployment on our cluster. So let's violate our policy. We've created a new service, which is equal to core v1.newService. We can pass in our context, a name for our service, which we'll call Nginx. And we want to pass in a core v1 service args. From here, we add the spec, which is going to be a core v1 service spec args. Inside of here, it's got a type, and we will set this to Pulumi string load balancer. Now, I'm not going to use the service, so let's just make that an underscore. And now when we come back to our terminal and run our Pulumi preview, apply in our policy pack, we should see the violation reported. Perfect. So that's CrossGuard and Pulumi's policy as code. Hopefully, based on what I've shown you today, you see how easy it is to get started. It doesn't matter which language you use for your policy or your Pulumi programs. You can get up and running very quickly. Take the default policies, add in your own, and secure your infrastructure. Have a great day.